Boogie Up the River by Mark Wallington, starring Timothy Spall. Episode 1, I'll see you at Tower Pier at 11.
I made a lot of phone calls that night. It was the eve of departure, and I was getting desperate. I was about to set off on a journey that might change the way we think about the world, and I couldn't find anyone to look after my dog while I was gone. I couldn't understand what all the fuss was about. Boogie is an intensely unattractive mutt, it's true, and he does have bad breath, and he is disruptive, and he hates children, and he molts over your toast, but he's good company.
Hello.
Douglas! It's Mark.
Oh, hi.
A favour, Douglas.
Yep.
I'm off on a trip tomorrow with Jennifer. We're going to row all the way to the source of the Thames.
You must be crazy.
Yeah, it's not going to be easy, I know. It's almost 200 miles and the Thames is a far less predictable river than people think.
Must be crazy going with Jennifer.
Listen, Douglas, I was calling because I thought you might like to look after Boogie while I'm gone.
Boogie? Your dog?
Yeah.
The dog you brought round here once before?
That's right, I think I did bring him.
The dog who ate my computer.
I didn't pursue the matter. Douglas has a better memory than I have. Instead, I phoned Marcia. Marcia would help me out. Marcia had looked after Boogie before.
Hello?
Marcia! It's Mark.
Oh, hi.
Marcia, I'm going away tomorrow for a month or so, and I...
You're not going to ask me to look after that horrible dog of yours again, are you?
Well, yes, I was.
I've only just repaired the damage he did to my ceiling the last time he stayed. Not to mention the dog hairs in the fridge. And I don't care what you say, I'm sure it was Boogie who got my hamster pregnant. No, I'm sorry.
I didn't pursue the matter. Instead, I called Radio Rentals. It was an outside chance, but Boogie spends most of his afternoons down there watching the racing in the shop window. It would be home from home for him. When I suggested this to the manager, he said...
Why should I want to do that?
He'd be a good guard dog. The only time he's ever bitten me was when I tried to move the telly. Boogie slouched into the room to watch Bilko. He smirked at me. A smirk that said, I've just been sick and it's your job to find out where. I had one last chance. Kennels. Unlikely, though. Boogie has a reputation in kennels. His mugshot is on the wall at Kennel Club head office with a warning underneath. The last time he stayed in one, all the other dogs complained.
Sit and stay boarding kennels.
Mrs. Matheson, it's Mr. Wallington.
We're full.
How are you, Mrs. Matheson? Is the leg better?
Chock-a-block, in fact.
Please, Mrs. Matheson, I've tried everywhere else. I'm going away tomorrow.
We're full until after Christmas.
I'd take him with me, but I'm going with a friend and she hates him.
In fact, looking at the diary, we couldn't fit him in before the year 2000.
Couldn't you keep him in the freezer or something? The news came on. Zainab Adawi reported on exchange rates and Boogie licked the screen. There was nothing else I could do. I just have to tell Jennifer straight. Boogie was coming with us and that was that. He would be ship's dog. And she'd have to accept the situation.
Jennifer Conway here. Leave a message, but please don't waste my time.
Hello, Jennifer. It's me, Mark. Shut up. Just calling to say, nothing really. I'll see you at Tower Pier at 11. Yeah, I said shut up! I can't wait. Bye. Informing someone they're going to be spending time in an enclosed space with Boogie should, in all fairness, be done face to face. A journey to the source of the Thames wasn't my idea. It was Jennifer's. Not that I'm blaming her for what eventually happened, and that would be unreasonable, but it was her idea.
Rubble lies like a corpse in the street, a concrete head with tarmac feet.
In fact, it was conceived round her flat one evening in April. We get together now and again for poetry sessions. We take our shoes off and eat olives, and she reads me her poems and asks for comments. Oh, they're wonderful evenings. It's such a shame her poetry is so dreadful.
Shrined, the black plastic bags of humanity drive Audi Quattros o'er the rubble of my solemnity. It's awful, isn't it?
No, it has warmth.
Hello? Yeah.
Jennifer's flat is in a Docklands development. Yeah. On the walls, she has picture frames with no pictures in them. On the floor, she has carpets from central Anatolia that really make your feet itch. I walk to the window and look down on the great curve of grey water. A hot air balloon bearing the name of a building society drifted effortlessly downstream towards Millwall.
Yeah, OK. Look, offer him a four-level multi-story for the price of a three. If he doesn't go for that, then I'll just put on my black dress and take him out for the evening.
I've never been quite sure what Jennifer does for a living. I think she sells car parks. I just know that she likes to be charming, but doesn't know how to be charmed. And she has hard edges.
Absolutely not.
The word rubble frequently appears in her poetry.
Yeah. Well, I know it's a gamble. I love a gamble.
I met her 2 years ago, by accident. A road accident, that is. She knocked me off my bicycle and took me out for cocktails to apologise. I've been under a spell ever since, I think.
Listen, if the man is willing to sell his grandmother, then I think the least we can do is buy her, OK? OK. You know, the two things I love most in life are poetry and money. Are you all right? You seem restless.
I've got itchy feet again.
Oh, you're not planning another trip, are you?
What?
Oh, that's what I like about you. You spend the winter with your head under the duvet, and then as soon as the clocks go forward, you get riddled with impatience. Oh, I know how you feel. I've only to hear the shipping forecast these days and I get aroused.
It's this carpet.
You know, I find it very sexy the way you just look out of a window and become inspired. What sort of adventure are you off on this time?
A river journey.
I'd love to go on a river journey.
Really?
Yes. Let's go together. I'll make it worth your while.
Oh. Any river in mind? I've always liked the sound of the Orinoco. Orinoco.
The Thames.
Or there's the Congo, of course. I think Thompson's do trips.
The Thames.
Or the Ganges. There are so many to choose from, aren't there?
The Thames.
The Thames?
Yes, the Thames.
You mean the Thames?
Yes. I want to travel to the source of the Thames.
Why?
Because it's here.
You mean because it's there? The phrase is, because it's there.
No, because it's here. Because it's here and because it's ours. And because it's right outside my window.
Ah.
I wrote a poem about the Thames once. Do you want to hear it?
Oh, I'd love to.
It's called, The River is Full of Rubble. Ready?
Ready.
Down river blows a plastic bag, the kind we call a carrier. It soars past Greenwich, Deptford and Blackwall until it hits the barrier. It's awful, isn't it?
No. It's got a certain...
No, it's appalling.
No, I like it. I think poems that feature Deptford are brave.
It took me a fortnight to write that.
No, I'd like to hear it again.
Really?
You bet.
Okay, then. Down river blows a plastic bag, the kind...
The Thames. Old Father Thames. A river that is here. A river that is ours. A river that flows right outside Jennifer's window. On the way home that night, I stopped on Blackfriars Bridge and peered into the black and gold water. And I followed a wave downstream and thought how in there was a drop that had sprung to earth almost 200 miles away and travelled through the water meadows of Gloucestershire, the farmlands of Oxfordshire, and the commuter belt of Berkshire. And it occurred to me how a journey to the source of this river had the potential of being one of the dullest quests ever made. But then I went and had a haircut and my opinion changed completely.
Northwest Spain. Oh, delightful, sir. My good customer, Mr. McDermott, he goes every year. Yes, they have the...
My hairdresser's name is Dario. Yes, Dario hasn't left Finsbury Park for 15 years, but every day...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.